Hey guys, I'm going to be doing a little painting video for you today using oil paints. This is just my little setup I wanted to show you guys before I started. This is what I'm going to be painting. I've got my brushes over here. I am going to be working in the Zorn Limited palette. That means I'm only going to be using four colors. I'm using titanium white, Payne's gray, cadmium red, and yellow ochre. This purple here is a mixture of all of these colors together. I painted a couple days ago and this was my leftover paint, so I mixed it into a nice mid-tone purple that I will also be using, but these are the only four colors. These are the tubes that I have right here, and that's all I'll be coloring with. So hopefully this will turn out and it won't look really silly on camera because I painted in an impressionistic style, so we'll see how that comes off on camera, but I will be doing commentary during this video and talking about the painting, so let's get started! I decided to include a bit of the prep work set up for this little painting, just so you can see like what colors I had sitting where on my palette. The palette I'm using is just like a little one of those like throwaway like waxy paper palettes that are good for travel. I have a wooden palette, but I only put paint on that when I'm outdoor painting, since I don't like having to clean it off. And then I'll go in, as you just saw, and I will kind of prep the canvas. I like to paint on a toned canvas rather than a just stark white canvas, so I just laid down a very watered down mid-tone purple, and then I let it dry for a couple seconds, or probably about a minute, and then I tapped off the excess water, so it left a very light purple tone on the canvas itself, so it's just not stark white, because I was trained to not paint on white canvases, so that's why I do that, and I actually do like having that kind of background tone rather than just painting on white. I also would normally do a tonal study on this, but I actually chose to do the tonal study on a separate piece of paper, and you can, when I showed that original video, you can kind of see it in the background, but I like to have that available to see so I know where I'm putting like my lighting and my shadows, so, but I was taught to put it directly onto the painting, but I didn't want to lose like the sketch underneath since I've never painted in my own style, one of my own characters before, so I decided to do my tonal study on a separate sheet instead of on the actual painting itself. This style of painting I actually learned from my animation teacher. I do have a bit of a background with oil painting. I've taken several classes when I was in college. You guys know, if you've been following me for a while, I went to school for animation and I took some oil painting classes, and my animation teacher she's still around. she's becoming a pretty well-known oil painter, and she's very, very talented, so I was fortunate to be able to take some classes with her. I took a plein air painting class with her, which is outdoor painting, and I live in Oregon. My school was in downtown Portland, so we went all over Portland and in the outlying areas and painted outside all summer, which was amazing. It was such a good class. I also taken at least one portrait painting class with her. I don't remember how many I took with her actually, but so I do have some experience portrait painting, and the portrait paintings we did were from live models, which was really cool. This style of painting is not like a typical style of painting. I would say that it's impressionistic, or like modern impressionism. It's a style that doesn't have any blending in it. Like all the colors that I'm laying down, I just kind of lay them down and just leave them be. That's the way I was taught how to paint, and I do really love the way it looks. From up close, it looks a bit strange, but when you back a bit away, it just looks really cool. Like the colors, your eyes automatically will make the colors blend together, which is why I have the camera pulled back a little bit in this video, just so that you can kind of get that effect, as like if you were standing a couple feet from it, it would look like it is fully blended together, even though it's not blended together at all. So this style is totally reliant on placing lights and darks next to each other and then blending them with a mid-tone value that you mix between those two colors. And it's a style that I haven't quite got yet. It's really hard. It didn't seem like it would be that hard, but it is kind of difficult to get it right. And like, I've been working on this like for several years I've been painting, but it is still difficult, and since this was the first time I had ever painted one of my own characters just from like my imagination rather than painting from life, I kind of was like, how am I supposed to go about doing this to make it look the way I want since I'm not working from a model, which is what I was usually used to. And I did find it a bit difficult to make her look like my own drawing style rather than like a real person which is normally what I would go for when I'm painting, but it was a really interesting challenge to try and figure out how to blend my own drawing and coloring style with this painting style that I know how to do but have never utilized as a way to color one of my own characters, if that makes any sense. Something else that I kind of struggled with a bit in this video is something that's a little bit silly, but I've actually never painted on a flat surface before. I paint with a French easel, and it's almost like completely vertical, so it's like right in my face when I'm painting because that's how it's comfortable for me. So I was like kind of almost like laying on my desk, and you can actually see me pick the painting up a couple times during the video to try and paint the way I normally would have painted, but I couldn't position my camera properly so that you could actually see what I was doing, because I would have liked to have the camera on my right side so that I would have got the sunlight, because I was working with natural light, which is another thing I have to talk about in a second, but I couldn't have the camera on my right because I'm right-handed, which was kind of unfortunate. Another thing that I had a bit of an issue with was lighting. So that's why the lighting is a little bit strange in this video, and you do actually see I just turned a lamp on, but I was working with natural lighting because my desk is by a big window now, but it got dark while I was painting, so I had to turn on a light, and I don't like having like artificial light on while I'm painting since I'm used to working outside, but because the paint, since I use really thick paint when I'm painting, it catches a lot of light, so it makes it look really shiny. I had it zoomed in a bit and you could see how shiny the painting itself became, and I knew that that would be a bit difficult to see on camera. But overall, I am really happy with how this little painting came out, since I've never painted in my own style before. It was a bit interesting to kind of figure out how to make it work for me. I did actually end up working on it a little bit after I stopped filming, but you'll see that in the final image. I think I'd like to do a couple more oil paintings for you guys. If you are interested in seeing that, you can let me know in the comments down below. I also was going to talk about my painting supplies, but I think I'm going to save that and actually do a whole video on it, since I know I'll get asked anyway. But I will leave what I did use in the comments down below like I usually do. And yeah, if you guys want to see a painting supply video, you can let me know in the comments down below. And if you want to see more oil paintings, I would like to do that. I wanted to have an image of this at the end, like I usually do in my videos, but since it's an oil painting and I use super thick paint, it's gonna take probably 2 or 3 weeks to dry, even though I hit it a couple times with my heat gun to try and dry it. I didn't get it, or couldn't get it dry enough so that I could scan it, so I had to take a photo at the end, which isn't ideal. I know, I like having a scanned image of it at the end, so I got a picture, which is the best I could do. And I just decided to include a little bit of my cleanup at the end here. You can see me mixing all the excess colors together to make a purple. And I just put that back in my little jar and I save it for next time. So I guess that's really all I have time for. Thank you guys so much for watching. There is the final image. And I will see you guys shortly for the next video. Bye!